going to need your attention for a moment. As Dilwat mentioned at the beginning of the semester, we have to submit a lab report, in fact, two lab reports. The first one is due next week. So it's a good moment to start to be writing. Today is going to be already the sixth lab, so you already have six labs to choose. So one of them, choose your favorite, so the ones that you got the best result, is going to be good. So I'm going to follow the syllabus. You already have this in point number 10 in your syllabus, but I gave you an extra notes that I wrote about how to display every part. Let's start for the title of your lab report. So the title usually is something that you do until you finish everything. So you are going to try to summarize in one phrase or few words, the minimal amount of words, what you did, what you understand. I don't know if you have seen the Big Bang Theory, the series, many of you. They start usually with a funny sentence that basically, if you think carefully, that explains what is going to be the chapter to be talking about. Something like that is going to be your title. Keep that until the end, very end, but you are going to be posted at the very beginning. So it's not going to be the same, for example, express a scissors, like to be a metallic rusted scissors. Can you see the difference? So in one title, we need try to be very specific about what you did. In the case of force, we are going to be using, okay, the minimal force applied to the motion of one car, something like that. It's how you can synthesize or summarize everything that you did in very few words. So it's going to be after you. Summary. The summary, even when it's the second part that is going to be evaluated for your lab report, is something that you do almost at the end. So because you have to synthesize or resume everything that you do, including your conclusions. So for this reason, even when you post in the second part, you do this almost at the very, very end. When you are already finished, you can say, okay, it has to include a little bit of your introduction, it has to include a little bit of your conclusions, what was the general report, what you did. Okay, introduction. Basically, in the introduction is the real first part that you are going to have your lab. The best way to start an introduction is try to use something that somebody already did. So we can use a book. So even you can Google. So in Google, you can find several of these topics about. But we need to be very careful because we don't want to use plagiarism. So we need to be very careful. Every source that you use, previous source, we have different citation. At the back, you are going to see in reference where you find a really easy recipe. It's an introduction only for citation. Probably in previous classes, your instructors told you, avoid plagiarism. It's going to be very important and how to avoid the plagiarism. Sometimes use one sentence or sometimes the formulas, even you need to use citation. So you are going to start your report really reading something that is in any book. Probably you can use the notes that you use from the lecture. It's something that you can use here. Okay, in the lecture we saw this, but don't forget, even if you use the notes from the lecture, don't forget the citation of your instructor. In this case, it's going to be Ms. Carola or it's going to be Mr. Farsin. So you can write citation, Mr. Farsin class. Don't forget the day that you took the class. So it's going to be part of something that you can start to use. I was using this. Okay. Feel free in this introduction to set off the objective for the laboratory. So what is the main objectives? For example, learn how much is going to one spring according to the mass, how much is going to extend or how much is going to be compressed. Or for example, today we have force, okay, the force obtained for friction, the normal force, the direction that you are going to have for everything. That's exactly what you are going to define the objectives. Even you can use in a lot of these things part of the introduction that are in your handouts. So feel free, don't forget to use the quotation marks to later use a citation. Materials use. I already mentioned that you are going to need to take pictures, try to describe what we have. In this laboratory, for example, we have a reel, we have several cards, different surface. It's exactly a little list, like a recipe, what you need. A computer with the program that is Capscon. We are going to need several masses. How many masses do you need? It's exactly what is going to be in that part. Make a list. Three springs is what you need in this part. So we are going to need a stand. So set up. The next part is really associated to this one. Sometimes you can compact the setup with the material used. Those pictures that I mentioned that you need to be taking during all these classes are going to be probably posted here. And you can say, this is the horizontal bar. We are going to have a diagonal that is going to support. We are going to have the springs. You are exactly describing in that list. Probably you can use numbers in that picture. This is this, this is this, this is this, to demonstrate what is going to be every part. Okay. Number six, description of the activities or activities done. Your handout is basically the same. So in your handout, you are going to find a lot what you did, but this for this part, for your lab report, you need to summarize a little bit more with your own words. For example, something that the syllabus says, set up, check that it is horizontal at the level. You can summarize. We were using a perfect horizontal and free of friction reel to use several, and we set up several cars. That one is going to be in past tense. At this moment, every sentence is going to be in past tense. You are going to find the text time that you are going to be used, but time at the end of every part of the introduction that you have there in this little description. Results. The results, for example, were the pictures when we were using the velocity versus time. All these dots, basically these graphics, are your results. If you got numbers, okay, I hope you were taking your picture or you sent yourself. You are going to be posting those graphics in the best way. It's a very good simplify. If you were doing math, it's exactly one table, you can express every single result. Number seven, analysis of results is possible, the source of error. For example, the analysis of result is when you were introducing in the program, what was this law? You have a lot of dots, but in the average, you have a horizontal line. That's exactly to make an analysis. The slope, some of you already summarized that, the slope was approximately 0.000. So that's exactly one result. The origin was 9.3, if you were calculating the acceleration of gravity. Okay, that is a good result, and the analysis, you start to make a hint about what is going to be the final answer, how you were obtaining all this. So you can use the statistic, the average. In some of the exercises that you did before, you were using average or you were using the median. Okay, that is exactly the analysis. After to this result, we were using the central one, not to the extremes. In parabolic shot, you were using that. So you can use that part. Conclusions. That is going to be the most important part. What you are going to conclude. For example, you were using, or you were trying to, the objective is the acceleration of gravity, and you obtain a value of 10.3 meters per second squared. Okay, it doesn't matter if it's not exactly what the theory predicts. In fact, conclusion, report what you obtain is going to be very important for science, even when it doesn't agree with what you were expecting. That is how science increase and improve. For example, when you report bad result, is we start to check what's going on, what was wrong. We start to check a possible source of error. One example, the first time that the CERN, the laboratory, was activated, that super machine that is try to collide particles. Some of these particles, the neutrinos, in the first report, they say that apparently they were faster than the speed of the light. According to the physics law, say nothing in this universe can be faster than the speed of the light. But that report turned the alarm to all these physics books. In fact, some of my students start to complain, professor, if we have that some particles are faster than the speed of the light, why we have to study all quantum mechanics and all these relativistic things? Because this is wrong, okay? Because everybody immediately start to check what's going on, how was that possible. After half a year, they found that it was a problem with connections with some circuits. They make that correction, and right now the results say, okay, these particles are not faster than the speed of the light. So this report, this kind of apparently bad conclusions and the possible hypothesis, something was wrong, so we were expecting this, but we obtained that, is something that is going to change and allow to the science to be improved. So in science, we never are 100% sure. Science is something that we can keep improving day after day, test after test. So this result that you are going to obtain today probably something that can be used in the future for the next generation. Okay, bibliography and the URL. So for bibliography, there are several styles. You need to define your own style, guys. I use the APA style or ML style. It doesn't matter, as soon as you use the same. So I gave you in those notes basically some formats that you can follow. It's not an absolute format. Feel free to improve. But for example, I have here one magazine. And let's try to use some of the format for magazine, how you make the citation of these magazines. That is in page number, let's see, page number 8. The fifth one. Let's try to choose this magazine. And you see it's going to be labeled in bold. It's going to be in bold, that part. They say last name, first letter of the name. So let's choose one article. Okay, I have here an example of a standard operating procedure for a surface analytical instrument. It's a very long title, but basically describing what they did. So we have several authors. So in this case, I have the last name first of the main author. That is going to be Dahlquist. Comma, and it has two names, so we use the initial CT for Cameron, and I don't know what is the name. If you have, use semicolon, if you have more authors, you can write 2, 3. If you have more than 3, usually you can use the et al. Et al. Is one, no? Okay. Et al. Yes. So, is how we describe for more hours. So the next part in this little format, okay, let's see. Year of the publication, it was published in 2018. Next part, we are going to need the title. It's a long title, we have to write everything. And example, of several things. I'm not going to be writing all of that, but you need to write all the title findings. Next part that is going to be important is going to be if you have a book, it's not a book, it's a magazine, so we have to use the second part. For magazine, the name of the magazine in italics. Usually in italics, it's going to be like vacuum. And creating technology. You can change to be in italics, so my case. Finally, we have the volume. So usually you are going to find the volumes of all the magazines
in the front page. Let me see, for this magazine, volume 19. The volume usually is abbreviated, volume 19, and the number. So you have a comma, number one. We use two dots to denote what page and how many pages you have for this article. Page 23 until page 27. That is exactly how you can make this kind of examples. Right now, we are in an electronic world where many magazines, many of these articles are on internet, on the media, but unfortunately, this kind of electronic source, they change, they don't last forever. When I was writing this text that I took from 20 years ago, when I wrote the first draft, I was checking my original reference, they no longer exist. So in case that you have to do some of this electronic reference, it's going to be very important to write cited or review and the date. For example, today is going to be 6th of June 2018. So that's going to be very important for your electronic reference, but probably in the future. And don't forget to use, before that, the URL. The www.that.something, if you use that. It's going to be very important for electronic reference. Basically, it's a summary of what you are going to find. Remember, it's going to be very important to have your citation, and you are going to post at the very end. But during all the time that you are writing your test, keep making the notes about all the citation. Right, in what page you are using this concept, because it's going to be important. Okay, guys, do you have questions about when to submit this material? Yes?
I used materials here on this lab, so do I have to reference them?
Yes, you can use a lab. Yes, lab reference.
Do I have to write lab notes?
You can use it, yes, of course. In fact, it's a good reference that you are going to be using, laboratory notes and the year that you were using. So we have, you can see in that labs that we have some authors. Yes. One question, guys? Don't forget that we are expecting to have, according to the APA style or ML style, Time New Roman, size 12, you can use double space. You need to print it and bring the day that is due. It's going to be important. Why double space? Usually, so you give a chance in this way to the tutor, probably your boss, probably your your instructor, to make notes. So when you are writing a thesis or when you are writing a report, a real report, in any kind of job that you are planning to do in the future, you're going to see that you need to be writing a lot. And it's very good to give a chance to your boss to take notes directly to fix, to improve your report. In professional world, usually we have peer reviews, and we interchange several times the same report to be improved several times. They say in page 12, in page 6, you need to do this, change this part, try to change graphic 1, graphic 2, graphic 3, take over. That is exactly what we have. Mm-hmm. More questions, guys? Okay, thank you. So we can start.